Bonjour, hello everybody, it's Pauline again, I'm back. Let's go on a cheesy adventure with the Emmental de Savoie. Emmental de Savoie, it's a fantastic French cheese, really old, making, since a while we make that in France. And it's a fantastic cheese with the red label. So red label means it actually needs to be made only in Savoie and matured only in Savoie. So we have the real one, that's good. After you need to know that it's actually one of the oldest cheese and the most produced cheese in France, 3,000 tons per year, so imagine it's a lot. And it works in fruitière. So fruitière, it's a kind of cooperative, so where you have the farmer, the producer, the milk producer, bring their milk to a house, a cheese making house, and over there you have a cheese maker who makes the cheese. So it will be different area of the mountain, different farmer, but the same cheese maker. So like that you have a more qualitative making and a better taste, better shape, better maturation, better everything, and much more traceability as well, which is quite important for cheese making. You need to know that to make this cheese, this one it's roughly 6 kilos. Let's look together, this big baby. We are 5 kilo 490, and usually a wheel of Emmental is actually 70 kilo. So imagine it's big cheese, so really heavy, but with the maturation we are helped by machine, so thanks really. But before it was actually whole handmade, so imagine. And then you need to know that to make a wheel, you need 850 liter of milk. It's huge. First, it's a lot of milk, okay? It's roughly 40 cows a day. So imagine every day. And then after, you need only to use, to be able to call it Emmental de Savoie, you need only to use 3 kinds of milk. 3 variety of cows. It's the most important. You have the Tarin, the Montbéliard, and the Abondance, that's the most famous in Savoie, and I forgot it, oops. But it's fantastic because the fact that we have only this 3 milk, the taste, the identity of this cheese will be always quite similar. Of course, it depends the season, if the cows are inside or outside, but it will always be really nice, fruity, woody, almost sherry kind of taste, and it's fantastic. So Emmental as well have a really strong particularity, which is usually only in this cheese that should happen. That's the hole. So this hole, hello, that's a beautiful natural reaction of the milk and what the cows eaten, okay? So when the cows eat good hay or good grass, you have always little particle who will go in the milk. Even if you clean the milk as much as possible, even if you do all the tests, you will always have a little bit of hay or a little bit of grass going in the milk. And during the maturation, when you age your cheese, you have a reaction going on, which is a kind of fermentation, we can say. So fermentation, like in alcohol making, but that will be to mature this beautiful cheese. And this fermentation will meet the hay or the grass, tiny particle, and will create this bubble. Because of course, if you don't have all that much with the protein and everything, that will not do that, but the Emmental do. So it's really particular and it's totally natural. Now with all the help of chemistry and biological, microbiological, you can actually now big producer of Emmental, like industrial, we will be able to say how many holes it will have in a wheel. So it's to tell you, it's actually quite crazy. This one is totally random, it depends. This one is actually a really good specimen, and it's what the best. Usually children love the hole, so it's quite funny, but French children always ask, oh, can I have the hole, can I have the hole? It's really important for them. After, that's a fantastic cheese. In particular to drink with wine. It's one of the cheese for me who goes the best with wine. In particular like light red or really nice Chardonnay or Jura wine or something like that. It's one of my favorite to pair. A lot of people use it for cooking, but forget it unfortunately for the tasting as well. So run to your cheese shop, and go buy some Emmental and let me know if you like it. And I see you next week. Bye. Au revoir.